Hi, I'm Norm Rasmussen, the co-founder of Precious Testimonies, or the Precious Testimonies Evangelistic Ministries. Precious Testimonies is a ministry that our marching orders from God, as much as we know to do, is to declare God's glory among the nations. Psalms 96:3 says to do that, declare God's glory among the nations. And there's a number of different ways to do that, but the way that God has called us to do that, this ministry of Precious Testimonies, is to publish testimonies of how God has worked in the lives of others so that others can be encouraged by how God has worked in the lives of other people, among other reasons why we publish them. But God just delights in us glorifying Him. He loves it when His created beings purpose to glorify Him and acknowledge Him and shout it to the world. We love you, God. You are awesome. That's all a part of the testimonies. But we teach from time to time. You know, we try to help out a little bit here or there with some Christian teachings that line up with God's Word. And so that's kind of what I'm doing here, doing a little exhortation, speaking on helping people trust God. We've been, you know, into the book of Proverbs in the Old Testament, chapter 3, starting with verse 5 and 6. If you've heard any of the other segments, I don't want to beat that to death, but maybe you've just clicked in here on, you know, the middle of this segment and what's this guy talking about. So give you a little background there. We're doing a segment series of how to trust the Lord. Keys to learning how to trust God or trust the Lord. And here in Proverbs 3, 5, it starts out, trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your paths. Paths is plural, okay? Not path, but paths. I'm reading out of the New King James Translation. And what is God saying here? If we do everything else up to this point, He'll direct our paths. In trying to get a handle on trusting God, as I've walked with Him, as of this taping, over 30 years, I've learned something that works for me. Okay, if it works for you, praise God. If it doesn't, well, you know, God relates to us differently. So let me just throw it out there, and you know, if it's useful to you, I'll just trust that God may help you get hold of it and apply it in your own life, in your journey with God. Okay? He says here, if we trust Him with all of our heart, we don't lean into our natural understanding, be obedient to Him in all the ways we know He wants us to be obedient, He's going to direct our paths. There was a time when I was so confused about what God would have me do, and I was letting Him know about that in prayer, and it wasn't a one-time thing. I'd been letting Him know for some days and nights how frustrated I was. Like this scripture wasn't working anymore, and I was frustrated. Well, God, why do it when You don't seem to be honoring my trust, and I just don't know what to do? I think a lot of it had to do with ministry, probably. But I felt that God sort of gave me a very faint impression. Maybe some would call it a vision. I don't know. I've never had a vision, but I get impressions, faint ones, but they work. And I saw a path going down, you know, just a path. And I saw Jesus in front of me. And I was following right behind Him. And as we walked a little bit, we were walking slow. Excuse me. And periodically there'd be a path peeling off to the left of the main path or peeling off to the right. And Jesus would stop and turn around. And He'd say, now, don't go left on that path going that way. Stay right behind me and follow me. Okay. And then we'd walk up a little further and there'd be a path peeling off to the right. He'd stop, turn around, look at me, and say, now, don't go down that path. Stay with me to follow me on this main path. I said, okay, I understand. And we did that a little bit, and He says, Norm, here is a way that all Christians, all people who consider themselves Christians, can come back to a place of peace with me when it seems like everything is chaos, helter-skelter in their mind, okay? Here's a way that you can always know you're on the right path if you've strayed off the main path that I want you to be on. It is to look to me, find me on the path I'm on, and get close behind me, and I will lead you. You can trust that I will lead you down the right path for you at any given time. And if you've gotten off the main path, hey, I forgive you. Turn around, come back, and get behind me and follow me. And when you're not sure how to find me, just go to prayer and ask me how to get you on the main course or the main path. And he's always done that. Sometimes I have, you know, a few days go by, and sometimes I have to spend more time in prayer than what I want to. Sometimes I've had to fast with prayer to see what path he is on and what path I got off onto and how do I get back on the main path. But he has promised, I'm not going to give you those New Testament scripture promises, but he's promised, peace I give you, peace I leave with you. That is a promise to all saved, born again Christians, okay? Disciples of Jesus Christ, if you will. He has promised to us peace. Peace that surpasses all understanding. Peace that in a world of chaos, he has a place, a sanctuary for us to hide in and abide in. And it is very near the Creator. Very near the co-creator, along with God the Father and God the Holy Spirit. His name is Jesus, okay? He is peace. He doesn't just impart peace. There's even scriptures that says he is peace. So the closer I am to him, the more peace I'm going to get. Makes sense to me. I don't want to be so far off that I'm just picking up a few frequencies or rays of his peace. I don't want to be so close to him I'm almost walking over him, okay? It pays big dividends to walk that close with him. But it takes diligence on our part oftentimes. Doesn't happen just because we wish it to happen. He sometimes makes us work a lot more than what our flesh would rather work to get that peace from him. I take such comfort, and I can speak from so many times past when I have been in a world of confusion and doubt and, God, what is going on? And what, and when is this old world going to stop churning? And when can I have some peace in my deepest parts of my being? And he'll say, come back to that path where I am for you. There's peace. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall, not maybe, not hopefully, he shall direct your paths, plural. Now, that gets into another teaching, okay? That means that you can be on, God may have you call, okay, do this for a job, marry this person, do this to your kids, do this in ministry, at church, do this, you know, whatever your responsibility is. So we have multiple choices to make almost every day of our adult lives, okay? And so many times we need God's direction for many different things that we have to be engaged in. We have to make decisions, and we want those decisions to be wise. We want those decisions to be endorsed by God so that we can trust God that he will help us accomplish whatever it is that God wills for us to accomplish as we go about making decisions. Okay, so decisions, plural, are paths, if you will. And he's saying here, I will direct your paths for every decision that you need to make. And I take so much peace in knowing he's promised me that. though it doesn't always seem to work as smooth as it sounds right here, okay, it has bore fruit. It has carried me through, and it keeps working. And anything I can get to keep working in my relationship with God, I'm going to keep doing until He determines it needs to be changed, modified, whatever, okay? And that's just the way I am. What works, I'm going to stay at it until God says, let's go in another direction. So with that, we're going to end it with that. I think that's enough for this session, and I'm trying to keep these a little shorter. And we'll just pick it up in the next part and see what we can come up with, okay? Thank you for let me have the opportunity to share. It's such a blessing to try to help somebody else in their walk with God, in their journey with God. It's tough, but it is the most important endeavor that we can do, is to get on the path that God wants us on and never get off of it or stay off of it very long. That's what it's all about, isn't it, my friend? Well, thank you, and God bless you.